coming. Today is Kara Watson's public defense of her PhD thesis. So Kara got a BS in biochemistry from the University of Nebraska-Lincoln. She joined my lab and was one of my first two graduate students. So when she interviewed, we didn't have chairs or pipettes. She wondered if the lab was for real. So she has helped us build the lab and has been really a big part of the spirit of the lab and building the B-cell part of the lab, which is one of our foundational interests in the Irish lab. And so when she started, she said that her interests were to use cytometry to understand B-cell biology, alterations in the immune system and human disease. She was especially interested in food allergies, in B-cell signaling and phenotype. And you'll see echoes of that throughout her thesis, which has ranged broadly across B-cell biology in healthy humans and in disease. She's been supported by the Microbiology and Immunology Program, my R00 grant, and the Vanderbilt Ingram Cancer Center. And afterwards, don't forget, we're having a celebration starting around 3 in PRB 749. And, okay, so Kara's work has had a broad impact on B-cell biology and on the mass cytometry community. So you'll see the data analysis and technical developments in mass cytometry are a big part of her PhD thesis. When she started, the CyTOF was number 17 in the world. It was a brand new technology, and Kara has helped build mass cytometry into what it is today, which is probably the most powerful immune characterization technology. Kara helped build the B-cell panel in the lab, so she influenced Hannah's paper in Journal of Immunology and contributed significantly to developing the B-cell panel there, and as well in her own paper with Kenuta Husa on follicular lymphoma B-cell biology, and she also helped develop the data analysis tools and was a contributor on Kirsten's paper on marker enrichment modeling. She's also helped influence others and has collaborated widely, and one of these collaborations in two posters is noted here with Lindsay Mueling and Judith Woodfolk's group on allergy. Kara's work also helped influence the B-cell panel that's now available in the core facility here in the Cancer and Immunology Core, and there's a reason it's panel number one. It's because it was the most advanced, and Kara's work really helped propel B-cells to the front of the list in terms of our CyTOF. So she's had a really broad impact on the B-cell team. She's also part of the quantitative biology team, which is really a very serious team. It's all business in the quantitative biology team. And so here is business, Unikitty, and Kirsten, who is also part of this team, and myself as Lord of Business. And so Kara's a great collaborator. She's really got a strong spirit and is really fun in the lab and is part of keeping people engaged and excited in their work and collaborates really broadly. But you can see she can also really get into this mess when she needs to. And she's, so Kara has collaborated throughout grad school with Kenuta Husa, who was part of her PhD work. And Kenuta, her lab is in Oslo. As a postdoc, she's going to Nils Hallberg's lab in Bergen. And I've collaborated for a long time with Bergen. And Monica is in our lab and is visiting from Bergen. And so we have an extensive Bergen connection. And we shouldn't have been shocked when Kara announced that she's doing her postdoc in Bergen, because she secretly put a little map of Norway and Scandinavia into figure one of her paper. After a while, you start seeing these T-stain plots look like different things. And so I think Kara's gone Scandinavia and Norway. And so we're thrilled that she'll be talking about her PhD work on B-cells in healthy humans and in human disease. And with that, I will turn the floor over to Kara to give her PhD thesis advice. Thank you.